Oops. Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's the day before the end of the new year, and I'm just want to give you an update on how my holidays are going and some changes that's going on in my life before we end the new year. So right now, what I'm doing right now is I'm going to show you all the things that I got and bought for myself for Christmas because I've been such a good girl. So yeah, this Christmas was okay. Yeah, but got some hot apple cider in my Rush mug. I can't believe 2021 has gone by so quickly. And they say the older you get, the faster time gets. So that's a word to the wise, yeah. So here's what I got for Christmas. I got some gifts from my Rush Secret Santa. I got two of them actually because it got odd and everything. I got one of them sent me two cans of Rush beer. Yeah, so, but I usually don't drink beer, but I keep them as a souvenir. Like, somebody can have a drink with them, but I'm keeping the cans for sure. I'm probably going to, thinking about putting them in a frame and framing and putting them up on my wall. So, and also, just a second. What, and also he gave me a Rush glass with the band Rush on it. And I love it. I've been using it ever since. I've been using it to like drink ciders and juices and all that. So it's going to come in very, very handy. So, and this is a really nice gift. So thank you. Also, I got some Rush stuff to put into my Rush collection album. I got a Rush Canadian Golden Ale sticker. I got a bunch of Rush Canadian Ale Golden Ale coasters. I got about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, about a dozen of them. And I also have a Rush 2112 envelope. Yeah, which I'm going to keep as a souvenir, which is really, really nice. It's sealed and everything, and also I have a Rush stickers as well. So yeah, from the mail. And I also got a couple of posters too. Also, I received a drumstick, another drumstick. It's a Pro Mark, autographed by Neil Peart himself, the late great Neil Peart. So I got about 5 drumsticks in total. So I'm figuring out what to do with the drumsticks. So I'm thinking about maybe framing these drumsticks and putting them up on my wall. So eventually it'll be a wonderful, wonderful decoration. Yeah. Also, I already have the book already, but eventually I got a good copy of it. It's a Neil Peart's Ghostwriter. I've read it before, and it is a really good book. This is a story about, within a 10-month period, Neil Peart suffered family losses so devastating that they left him a ghost, physically a man, but with nothing. No hope, meaning, faith, or desire to keep living. 1 year after the first tragedy, Neil was choosing between life and his own death. Finally, all he could decide upon was motion. He got on his BMW R1100GS motorcycle and over the next 14 months rode 55,000 miles in search of a reason to live. On a journey of escape, exile, and exploration, he traveled from Quebec to Alaska, down the Canadian and American coasts and western regions to Mexico and Belize, and finally back to Quebec. While riding the healing road, Neil recorded in his journals the progress and setbacks in the grieving healing process and the pain of constantly relieving his losses. He also recorded with dazzling, colorful, entertaining, and moving artistry the enormous range of his travel adventures from the mountains to the sea, from the deserts to Arctic tundra, and the dozens of memorable people, characters, friends, and relatives he met along the way, and who increasingly contributed to his healing and sense of meaning and purpose. He begins the journey with nothing, the Ghost Rider. What he finally attains is joy, love, and indelible moments of the most extraordinary journey of his life. Ghost Rider is a bold, brilliantly written, intense, exciting, and ultimately triumph narrative memoir from a gifted writer and musician who started out as a man reduced to trying to stay alive by staying on the move. Yeah, it is such a good book. It reminds me of me back in 2011. So I would call Neil my spiritual wolf. Like, he guided me through my difficult times back in 2011, 2012. So this is a must read. And I also have an extra one. So I'll figure it out. Also, my neighbor, I got a gift from my neighbor, and it is so awesome. Like, she knows me very well. And this is a Rush Farewell to Kings 1977 t-shirt, which is an extra, extra, extra large, which is really, really nice. So, but I'm putting it in the laundry so it could maybe shrink down a bit, but I could maybe use it to wear to bed or something, or lounge around the house. So, but I usually like to wash things first before I wear them. Yeah, because you never know. Okay. Also, I got this off Amazon, and it is an awesome present. And, I received, like, gift cards from Amazon and all that, so I used them up for Christmas and all that. And what I got is, it's a must for every Walking Dead fan. It's called The Art of the Walking Dead Universe. And it's discover the behind-the-scenes pre-production and production art for AMC's The Walking Dead shows. The Walking Dead, Fear the Walking Dead, and The Walking Dead World Beyond. And then all in one incredible collection includes never before seen original sketches, concept art, storyboards, previs art, set concept and engineering art, promotional concept to completion key art, special product illustrations and world product art, and much more. Features an introduction by Chief Content Officer Scott M. Gimple, as well as other compelling anecdotes and fun facts from the Walking Dead universe creators and crew. A must-have for anyone who has ever shouted, "We are the Walking Dead." So this is an awesome book, and I'm so glad I got it. I love it. Mm-hmm. Also, I went to the Source last week, and I bought myself some things that I really, really need. I got a new laptop. I needed an upgrade because it's been 4 years already. So I think it'd be good if you switch up your computers from every 4 to 5 years. So yeah, but eventually, costs a lot of money, but I got my way. So I got it's from Skullcandy. These are mini mighty wireless earbuds. I really wanted a pair of those wireless earbuds without the wires and all that. I bought some from like Canadian Tire a few years ago, but they were terrible, and I had to get rid of them. So eventually, always go to a place like the Source, Best Buy, or something technical for technology purposes. But I paid a great deal. Buying both of them. And the other one is the Featherlite More Music wireless earbuds. Yeah, because one of my earbuds from my old one that I got a couple of years ago was falling off. So it's time for me to upgrade to a new one. So they're both Bluetooth wireless, and I got these both for $70. You're originally priced at like over $100. So I saved a lot of money. So when you go to places like the Source or Best Buy, find a great deal, because you can be very, very lucky, because I'm very lucky to have these. Okay, also, what I bought for myself, got for myself, this is, I've seen these before on like Amazon, TikTok, and all these. So, all this stuff. And so, this is, it's called a stainless steel herb cutter. It can do, it's not only an herb, it's also a herb stripper. It says, it's an, okay, I'll take it out here. This is what it looks like. And this is just a blade guard. Okay, what this is, it's a 9-hole design for most vegetables, sand stems, and leaves. There's an edge blade. Not only can remove leaves, but also cut large leaves of vegetables, like kale and all that. And it's also a safe protection cove with a buckle, prevent hurting your hand. So this is a safeguard right here. And it's a 2 millimeter thick stainless steel, more sturdy, no deformation. So it's got all the herbs that you can put through. Like if you want, you need a few, like there's from down there all the way to the big ones. Not too much, because I don't buy a lot of fresh herbs like I used to anymore, because it can go really bad really quickly, especially parsley. Every time I have to buy a big batch of parsley, bouquet of parsley, it always goes bad really, really quick. So be very careful if you buy parsley and all that. So it's also a chopper as well. So usually, like when I order from HelloFresh, that's where I usually get my fresh parsley, because it'll last. Yeah, because I won't waste a. I wasted a lot of money if you buy a bunch of parsley, and that's why I buy it in frozen cubes now. So it'll be good. It'll still be good, but good. Yeah. The parsley can be used for decoration, like even if you're working in a restaurant. This is the best way to. It's the best way to go. It's also a stripper and a cutter. Okay. Next up, I scored in the movie department, on Amazon, and I got it. Like it was Black Friday sales. You know, Black Friday. You never go into a mall on Black Friday because it's a real huge mob in there, and So that's why I usually don't go inside malls and all that on Black Friday. Yeah, ordering online is the best way to go. I got one movie that everybody says it's the best Christmas movie ever, and I also got its sequel. But the movie came out in the summer of 19. One came out in summer of 88, and the other came in the summer of 1990. And they're both set at Christmas time. Yeah, but people say it's a Christmas movie, and they like Gremlins and Trading Places too. So this movie is this is a much the first two, but the rest of them I did not care for. So like they all say, if everybody agrees with me, this is what I got: Die Hard and Die Hard 2 with Bruce Willis. Oh, like even if you say, yeah, having a party it's a Chinese strange, it's a strange Chinese saying, but building. But every time I see Alan Rickman fall from a building, then it's the yep. Then this is a movie. These two you must have: Die Hard and Die Hard 2. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Also, I got another Christmas movie that came out recently, and that came out back in 2015, I believe. And it is so, it's my first time seeing it, and I saw the cover of it, and it looks really, really interesting. It's from the guys who brought you This Is the End and Neighbors, and it stars Joseph Gordon-Levitt, Seth Rogen, and Anthony Mackie. It's about three best friends and one epic party. And it's called The Night Before. Okay, it's about Ethan, who played by Joseph Gordon-Levitt, Isaac, Seth Rogen, and Chris Anthony Mackey, have been friends since childhood, and for a decade, their yearly Christmas Eve reunion has been an annual night of debauchery and hilarity. Now that they're entering adulthood, the tradition is coming to an end. And to make it as memorable as possible, they set out to find the Nutcracker Ball, the holy grail of Christmas parties. Like, I saw it for the first time. It is so funny. I laughed at a few things. I laughed at a few parts. Also, another good Christmas movie is Office Christmas Party. It is hilarious. Also, I got one of those a classic Christmas movie. Like, my all-time favorite classic Christmas movie is always It's a Wonderful Life. And this stars Bing Crosby, Danny Kaye, Rosemary Clooney, and Vera Ellen. Like, I watched it for the first time a few years ago, and I fell in love with it. And it's probably one of my grandparents' favorite films, or my mom's favorite. And it's Irving Berlin's White Christmas. Yeah, good old Bing Crosby and Rosemary Clooney. Okay, White Christmas is a treasury of Irving Berlin classics, among them Count Your Blessings Instead of Sheep, Sisters, Mandy, and the beloved holiday song White Christmas. Two talented song and dance men, Bing Crosby and Danny Kaye, team up after the war to become one of the hottest acts in show business. One winter, they join forces with a sister act, Rosemary Clooney and Vera Ellen, and trek to Vermont for a White Christmas. Of course, there's the requisite fun with the ladies, but the real adventure starts when Crosby and Kaye discover that the inn is run by their old army general, who is now in financial trouble. And the result is the stuff dreams are made of. Okay, so eventually, also, it also has the song, "We're Having a Heat Wave, Tropical Heat Wave." Usually, sometimes the song gets stuck in my head, so eventually, this is another Christmas classic that you should have in your collection. Also, I got another Christmas collector's movie. It's a classic children's tale. It's from it's from Rankin and Bass. You know, the shows they did, like Santa Claus is Coming to Town, The Year Without a Santa Claus. Yeah, this one is on CBS almost every single year, and every time it comes on, I always watch it when I was growing up. It's the deluxe edition of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Yep, it's newly improved picture quality. It says, "Have a holly jolly Christmas with the most famous reindeer of all in the original holiday special, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. After being told he could not play in any reindeer games due to his glowing nose, Rudolph sets out on a fantastic journey where he meets Hermie the Elf, Prospector Yukon Cornelius, and a host of misfit toys, all while trying to hide from the abominable snow monster. It's a race against time as the family and Clarice try to find him during a big snowstorm that threatens to cancel Christmas. Based on this timeless story and song, Rankin-Bass production of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer features groundbreaking animagic stop-motion animation, narration by Burl Ives, and unforgettable songs including A Holly Jolly Christmas, Silver and Gold, and We're a Couple of Misfits. It's pure holiday magic for the entire family. Also, another movie I got, I saw this in the theater 2 years ago, two summers ago, and I thought it was really good. It was well acted and well done, and it's directed by Danny Boyle, who did Slumdog Millionaire, which was really good, which he won the Oscar for. And this film is called Yesterday. It reads, from the Academy Award-winning director of Slumdog Millionaire and the writer of Love Actually, everyone in the world has forgotten the Beatles, except Jack. It's called Yesterday. And it's a heartfelt comedy, and it's really good. So if you're a Beatles fan, this is what you need to have. Okay. Jack Malik was just another struggling songwriter, but that was yesterday. After a mysterious blackout, Jack, played by Himesh Patel, discovers he is the only person on Earth who remembers the Beatles. As the rock is to fame by passing off as the Fab Four songs as his own, Jack risks losing Ellie, Lily James, and the one person who has loved him and believed him in him from the start. Before the door to his old life closes forever, Jack must decide if all he needs is love. After all, Kate McKinnon and Ed Sheeran also star in this romantic rock and roll comedy from Academy Award-winning director Danny Boyle and Academy Award-nominated screenwriter Richard Curtis. So if you are a big fan of the Beatles, if you love the Beatles, you'll love this movie yesterday. You could have it in your collection. Okay, now I got some cool stuff off of Amazon that just came in. They all came in at once, which was very surprising. So let's open them all up. Now I got this package, and let's see what I ordered. Wow. Now what we have here, these are called Danish whisks. Yeah, these are Danish whisks, and what they're for, they're like to mix the dough, mixing dough. It's called Danish dough whisks, and I've seen these on video blogs saying that these Danish whisks are the best ones to use if you want to stir cakes or stir any kind of dough besides the wire whisk ones where you like beat the eggs and all that, but these dough whisks will come very, very handy. Yeah, paid a good price for them, but I got two for the price of one, which is awesome. Okay, let's see what this one is. Got another one. Okay, you got it here. Oh! I got some mouthwash that I'm in subscription. Like I get a bottle every 3 months or so, but eventually I got plenty, so I'm probably gonna stop for now because I got plenty enough mouthwash to last me for a whole year. And also I got, this is a reheat, this is a USB ported reheated coffee mug. Yeah, because I have one right here, but it's starting to, got it 2 years ago, but it's starting to slow down a bit on heating, so I got a much better one. Like I ordered a black one, but okay, let's see what color this is. I ordered a black one. If it's black, I'll be happy. If it's pink, I'll be fine with it. I like pink too. It's a heating cup. Okay. Come on. Come on. Oh, it is black, which I love. Yep, this is it. This is a heating mug. And it also comes with okay. Yeah, it's like you put the power on, power off, like, but eventually it's not a USB port, but eventually it will keep my hot drinks hot for hours, warm for hours, so, which is awesome. Okay, let's go. We got a few more here. A couple more. And we got a box here. Let me find my keys. Mm-hmm. Okay, here we go. Okay. Okay, open one box. Bubble wrap. We all need bubble wrap because we got to put our Christmas decorations away soon. For another year. Okay, oh, what do we have here? What I got here, wow. What this is, I got off Amazon. This is, it's a noise-canceling headphone set, which is lightweight, designed for comfortable fit. It's by Vanco, and it's breathable mesh and soft memory protein ear pads, hi-fi stereo sound and deep bass, up to 30 hours of battery life, foldable construction for easy packing, and it also makes clear calls with CVC 8.0L dual mic technology. So, like, this is awesome. Like, I got a pair last year from the source, but I didn't really use it that much. But so eventually I got this, so I got a little upgrade, so, which is awesome. Okay, and now one more box here. Okay, one more box. Oh, it's a lot here. Now, what do I have here? Oh, I got a lot of stuff. Now, the stuff I've been waiting for. Okay. What I got here. This is Erase Your Face, and it's great for, it's better than those disposable makeup pads. Like, you can use them a few times. Just only you rinse, use warm water, and then just take off your makeup. Yeah, and you wipe away the makeup and then rinse. Yeah, and you also rinse and hang to dry. But you can always put them in the wash with cold water. So these will come in very handy. So Erase Your Face is the best. Erase Your Face, this is called. Yeah, everybody should have one, because I already got one already and I could use some extra more. Like, this will save you money on makeup removing wipes and all that. It'll be a money saver. For this. Also, I got a 3D sleep mask. Yeah, which is also good for sleep, travel, rest, and game. Like, it's got... it's a pretty care sleep mask. It's made from high-quality material and adopted advanced staining technique to retain the best color fastness and reduce color fading. However, cosmetic residue or sweat may result in slight color fading. Please hand wash or machine wash with laundry bag before first use. Which is not bad. Okay, so this is a 3D sleep mask, which is awesome. Like, you can listen to. Yeah, so it'll be great for, like, listening to music and all that. Okay, let me open this up here. Okay, oh, this is a pretty care, but this is a lot bigger than the one I had before, so. Yeah, so you should wash it first, yeah. And it also it also has a laundry bag. Oh, and it's got its very own laundry bag, which is awesome, so. So you just gotta take everything out here, and so it'll be awesome. Like, it's a lot bigger than my old one, so, but eventually this is awesome. Trust me, it is. Also, I got some more micellar cleansing water. I got some from Nivea a couple of years ago. I still have some, but eventually Eventually, they say Micellar Water is the best makeup remover, eye makeup remover you'll ever have, and this stuff is amazing. Yeah, so after you remove your makeup with your Erase Your Face cloth, yeah, best to use afterwards, put some like on a cotton pad or something like that, and put some micellar water to wash off the rest of the residue of the makeup. Also, I got, everyone's getting those these days. These are reusable pads. These are organic bamboo cotton. There are 20 reusable in them. And we have to wash the pads before use. There are 20 reusable pads. Yep. They're zero waste. Save your money on cotton pads and all that. So eventually I'll show it to you. Okay. Oh, it comes in its own mesh washing bag. And yeah, you always have to wash everything before first use. It comes in its own washing bag, and wow. That's going to save you a lot of money for buying. Like, these are nice, soft, made of bamboo, and they are very good. Good for like removing eye makeup or putting on your cleanser and all that. It'll save you a lot of money from buying eye makeup remover and a lot of cotton pads so you can save the environment, which is awesome. Also, I saw these on TikTok many times, and I got these, and these are called Miscellaneous. They're leggings, and they're extra large, and like, you know, when you see the women in these tights from TikTok and all that, put it on their album, and it's designed to make your butt look. So I'm gonna try these on, and still, if they do fit, I'll wear them tomorrow, which is really nice. Then these are very comfortable, and this is the back, which is really, really comfortable. Yeah, because I've seen them before, and I only paid about they're like $20, which is an amazing price. So wish me luck in trying these on. And finally, this is what I really needed for winter, because there's not much snow around here lately. So eventually what I got here are brand new winter boots. These are great. They're like fashionable boots where you just slip these boots on, and you don't have to worry about the zippers falling. Like, it also has like a Velcro on the side, and your boots could fit perfectly. Like, it'll keep your feet warm. Keep your feet warm and all that. It's got like this cushion here, so that it will really keep your feet warm. Your feet will feel so comfortable in these. I just love these boots, which is awesome. If there's snow on the ground, if there's ice on the ground, then I don't want to get injured and all that, because the boots I have are about right now are like falling apart, and they're like 6 years old or something like that. So it was time to get a new pair of boots. So they're called snow boots with a casual sneaker. They're like sneaker boots, which are very, very awesome. So, okay, well, that's it for me. And thank you for joining me about all the Christmas stuff. And now that Christmas is almost over, it's going to be a new year. 2021 was, it wasn't too bad of a year, but it's starting to get better. Yeah, we got we got both got vaccinated, but now we need the third booster to make sure. So we may go into another hit another wave or something like that. So eventually, this is like hopefully for 2022 that I will find employment and I will get to travel again and do other things. So eventually, so at least the curse to, since now that 2021 is almost over, it is now time. I can't wait for the year 2022 to start. That means out with the old, in with the new. So that's my agenda. So, and my place is kind of a mess right now. So I'm going to go clean up a bit before New Year's. And I want to get to the laundromat before New Year's Eve. So I think I should like go to bed a bit early tonight. I was going to go today, but I overslept for some reason. It was kind of a bad day yesterday. So eventually, I'm gonna stick around. Kept a download today. So eventually things will get better by tomorrow. So if you have any questions or comments, you want to subscribe to my channel, please do so, but please be very respectful. That's my only rule. So this is me, Rushdead Dixon Vixen, saying good night, God bless, and if I don't see you again, hope you had a great Christmas, and hope your new year is going to be a good one. See you then.